Hello and welcome to a new Django project in our backend development series. In this tutorial, we're going to build a login logout system using Django Web Framework, and we're going to make use of the Django built-in authentication system. Now, before we get started, I would like to show you the end result. This is our Retro Gamers Club dummy website, and we have just created the login page. You can see here that username and password, I didn't create these fields. These fields were provided as out-of-the-box features from the Django authentication system. If, for example, you will click on login, you will have this message telling you, please fill out this field. And again, I didn't create that, but this was provided by Django auth system. So let me show you. If you will enter your username and your password, click on login or hit enter, you will be redirected to your home page. Okay, welcome back to Retro Gamers Club. Thank you for logging in. So we were directed from the login page to your home page. Okay, these are two different pages. And we can click on logout. Now you are not logged in. If you would like to log in again, you'll click on the link and you will log in again. And you're going to see that with very few lines of code, you can create this login functionalities thanks to the Django authentication system. So let's go ahead and start creating our project. I'm going to create a folder and I will call it login form. I'll open that with Visual Studio Code. You're free to use any text editor that you like and you feel comfortable with. I will use here a virtual environment. And if you have been following me, you know that I like to use pipenv. So I'm using pipenv for installation of Django first. And if you don't have pipenv, you can install it simply by using pip install pipenv. And I'm not going to hit enter because I have it already. So once that installed, or if it's installed already, you can go ahead now and type pipenv install Django. And this will install automatically Django inside your login form folder. And then we're going to activate the pipenv virtual environment before creating the project. All right, good. Now let's clear the terminal. And let's go ahead and activate the virtual environment using pipenv shell command. Great, now the virtual environment is activated. And we can go ahead and create our project. So django-admin start project. And I'm going to call my project login form. Now let's go ahead to login form. Good. And let's migrate. So python manage.py migrate. Okay, good. And let's go ahead and run the server. So python manage.py run server. Just to make sure that everything is working okay. Okay, cool. This is the welcome page of Django Web Framework. All right, let's go ahead and open our project. Login form in settings.py. And when you will scroll down, and we'll go to installed apps, you will find that Django has provided us with Django contrib.auth. Okay, this is where auth is one of the several built-in apps Django has installed for us. So in order to use the app, we need to add it to the urls.py like we would normally do in case we have created an independent app here. Notice that I didn't create any independent apps because actually Django has installed this for me. So I can make use of this and create my login form. But as I said, we need to add it to the urls.py like we would normally do in case we created a separate app. So I will need to add include here and I need a different path. All right. And this one, I will call it accounts and I will show you why in a second. And here I will include you know what? Let me actually show you on the website in order to understand better the source of this accounts and what will be included inside the parentheses. So this is the Django documentation and I will leave all the links in the description below. So take a look. Authentication views. Django provides several views that you can use for handling login, logout, and password management. And if you'll go just below, you'll find that in the URL patterns, this line is included. So path, accounts, okay, so this is the route, and we want to include django.contrib.auth.urls. All right, as I showed you that in installed apps, we have here django.contrib.auth. Okay, and we're going just to access another level, which is the URLs. So actually we can copy that and we can paste it here. All right, so this route is going to be used in order to log in. So let me get back to the website. You will find here different routes, okay? And we will need to create a template for each URL pattern. So if we want the login page, for instance, we will need to create our login page. And Django by default looks for authentication templates within a folder called registration. So if you will take a look here, so template name, the name of a template to display for the view used to log the user in, defaults to registration folder. Inside it we'll have a login.html. All right, so let's go ahead and do that. So as usual, you can create your templates folder. Inside your templates folder we will have registration folder, and inside that we'll have our login.html. right, so let's close that, close that. So make sure to create your folder inside the login form. So click one more time, create your folder templates, inside templates create registration folder, and inside that login.html. okay, and that's it. So I'm going to show you how to write the very basic login page. So let's have an h2 tag, login, we'll have form, not action but method, and this is post method, right? And we'll need the CSRF token for security reasons, and I've talked about that in different videos. I will also leave the link to that in description below. So CSRF token, and be careful that CSRF token is used only for internal redirection, for internal changing of routes, okay? It's not used externally, because if we'll use that externally in your form, you will risk the leaking of that token. This is used only internally. And I'm going to use form.asParagraph. And this is provided to us by Django Authentication System. Again, I'm using what Django is providing us. We don't have to type two different input fields, username and password. Just form.asParagraph, and it will be created to you automatically. All right, I will need a button with type of submit. All right, in here type login. Right, and that's it. That's all what I need. And later I will copy and paste the whole code for the dummy website or the dummy login page that I've showed you in the beginning of the video. But for now, the most important thing for me is for you to understand how the functionalities work. Then later you can add colors, you can add icons, pictures, whatever. You can play with that as you like. Let's not forget to update this settings.py. Here in DIRS, in templates, I will need to add stir base DIR. And I've also talked about that many, many times, and I have a different video on how to render HTML pages, CSS, JavaScript, and image files. Make sure to check that out. All right, now the basic login functionality works. But to make it better, we should specify where to redirect the user upon a successful login. So when you will hit enter or click on login, where should you be sent on the site or redirected to? Okay, so we use the login redirect URL setting to specify this route. So I will type that below here, below static URL, login redirect URL, And later we will change that when we will create the home page. All right, perfect. The last step that's remaining is to create a super user. So I will hit Control C to stop the server, and we'll say Python manage.py create super user. And let's use a different name. Let's say ken@aol.com, password 123456. 123456. That's okay. All right, now let's go ahead and run the server again. Python manage.py run server. Let's open again the page. And that's fine. Page not found is absolutely normal because we don't have the home page. All right. Let's go ahead and type slash admin. So Ken 123456. So you see, this is the admin website, okay? And this is another app provided to us by Django. This is used usually for the content manager or the users of the website or the web application. So I will leave this open and I will open a different tab. Okay, 127.0.0.1 port 8000 slash accounts slash login. All right, and this is our basic login form. So if I will enter Ken, the same credentials, the same username that I've created in when I did the create super user command, and the same one that I've used in order to access my admin site, I will use it also in my login form. 123456, click on login, and notice that we have used just form.as paragraph or as underscore b, and Django has created username and password with the fields and with the functionalities. So let's show you that quickly. You see that if I will click on login, I'll have please fill out this field. All right, so let's use our username Ken 123456. Hit enter or click on login, and perfect, we have been redirected to the home page. And that's absolutely fine because, again, as I said, we did not create a home page. So let's go ahead and create our home page, or index.html. You can call it whatever you like. So let's close that, let's close that, let's also close that, and let's shut the server for the moment. And I will just create a simple page to welcome the user for the successful login. Okay, so we can go ahead and create login inside templates, but not inside registration. So you can click on templates, index.html. All right. And again, I will create, as I said, the very simple, the basic code to create a home page. And later I will show you how did I create that website that I've showed you in the beginning of the video. And for that, I used Bootswatch. Okay. So let's go ahead and create block content. All right, and this is the Django template language. It's very similar to Flask's Jinja template language. So block content, and at the bottom here, we'll need to close that block. So end block, and I want to check out. And here I will have a condition. If the user is authenticated, then I want to display or render a welcoming message. Else, I want to render a different message. Say, for example, you're not logged in. All right, and that's it. So I'm going to use again the curly braces, double percent sign, and if user dot is authenticated, in this case, I want to have an H2 tag. I'll say welcome. And I want to plug in the username. So for that, I will use the double curly braces, user.username. Else, I want to say you are not logged in. All right, so. Then I want to add the link to login page. I will add an anchor tag with the reference of, again, I'm using the Django template language, URL, and login. And we'll type log in, not on in. All right, and that's it. And don't forget to end the if statement. So end if in one word. Okay, so that's the whole code. I would create an app like I do every time, but I decided not to, because this approach will lead to the same results if I would create different views in the app. Plus, we don't have to worry about databases, but again, you're free to create an app if you want and fill the views file and create another URLs file and so on. But for now, I will go to URLs and I want to import the template view. So say here from django.views.genericBase, I want to import template view, not response, template view. And here below, let's actually add another path for the home page or for the empty route. So I will leave it empty and I will use the template view dot as view. And inside here, I want to specify the template name to be the index.html. So the main argument is template name is equal to index.html, name equal to index. So let's go ahead and run that one more time. And here, let me just log out first. So Ken, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, enter. And boom, we have Welcome Ken, our welcome page that we have created. Fantastic, so it works, but how do we log out? The only option currently is to go into the admin panel. So let me log in again. So log in again. All right. And if I will just refresh, I'm still logged in. But if I will click log out, I'm logged out. If I will refresh here, and now you can find our message that we have written in our index.html with the link. But it's quite annoying to go every time to the Django administration. There is no point to do that. Let's fix this by adding a logout link to the home page in index.html so you or the user can easily switch back and forth. All right, so let's get back to our code. And fortunately, Django Auth app already provides us with a built-in URL and view for this. So we don't need to display anything on logout, so there's no need even for a template. All really we do after a successful logout request is redirect to another page. That's it. Let's go to our index.html. So let's go ahead and add the link to the built-in logout URL, and we will add it below here after the welcoming message. So we will need another anchor link, and we'll do like we have done below. So again, these curly braces with the percent sign, URL, logout. And that's all. We don't have to do anything else. All right. And just here we will type log out. So hello, welcome. Then if you want to log out, you can click on that. If you're not logged in, then you will have the message you are not logged in and another link with the login. It's simple as that. It's very logical, very simple. So in settings.py, like we have done in the login redirect URL, we'll need to do the same thing with the logout. All right, so it's basically the same. Instead of login, it's logout. And actually, now we have a homepage view. We'll go to URLs. We have a homepage view. We have index now, right? So we should use that instead of our current hard-coded approach like we have done here in settings.py. So instead of this forward slash, we'll substitute it by index. And that's all. Let's go ahead and give it another try. You're not logged in. So let me actually go to accounts, login. So here we have our login page. All right. Username Ken, password 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Login. Perfect. Welcome Ken, and we have a link logout. If we'll click on logout, now you're not logged in. Click on login again. You are redirected to the login page. All right, perfect. Now let me copy and paste the main code that I have written for the index and the login HTML. So for the index first, okay, and for the login, this is an HTML boilerplate, okay? Here is the Bootswatch CDN.js, and I will leave the link to that below. And if you want to take a look now with me, so we can type Bootswatch, let's take a look to Bootswatch first. And I have created a weather app in this channel, and I have used the same theme, Cerulean, because I don't know, I like it. I like that blue color, that blue tone. Okay, but you're free to choose from, you see, you have a lot of options. And to use that, I have used the CDN. So Bootswatch CDN.js. Click on that link and take a look. Cerulean, the first one here. You will copy the link tag and you will paste it here. Then you will use the Bootstrap classes and so on. All right, so this is for the Bootswatch. This is for the Google fonts because I have used the PressStart 2P font to give it a little bit of that retro feeling. You can go ahead and check that out in Google Fonts. Google Fonts. Okay. And here you can search for Press Star 2P, that one. Click here. And you can click on Select this style. All right. And you can grab that link here, that link tag. And for the font family, you will use Press Start 2P and Cursive. Okay. So that's the link. Title login page, that's okay. Body with a class of Jumbotron. And all of that is Bootstrap classes, guys. Plus my styling, my own styling. So I added here an emoji for a joystick, retro gamers. It's very, very simple. Okay, with spans and so on. But the main code remains the same for the Django template language. Okay, so this is the login page. Let's save that. And for the index page, the same. So you can use, by the way, you can create base.html and use the inheritance of the base.html in different pages. So for instance, if you're going to create different pages, for example, contact, news, blog, and so on, you can create base.html, and in order to reduce code, you can just inherit from the base.html the general styling that won't be changed across your website through the different pages, right? But I didn't need to do that here, as we just have the login and the index, so that's okay. Again, class Jumbotron, see your news, retro blog, gallery contact. And again, the main code, the main Django template language code is the same, all right? So here you can see hello or welcome and give it some span just to add a color to the username, to Retro Gamers Club. Thank you for logging in. And you're free to change all of that. Just do on your own styling. I'm quite sure that you have a good taste of colors and design. Okay, so let's take a final look. Let's just make sure that the server is running. All right. And 127, 8,000. You're not logged in. This is the main page. We're just reader because we're not logged in. So we'll need to go to accounts/login. And there you go. You have the main login page. Ken, 123456, enter. Retro Gamers Club for retro geeks and nerds with a joystick. Welcome Ken to Retro Gamers Club. Thank you for logging in. You want to log out? Click on logout. Now you're not logged in. Log in again and so on. All right, so that's it guys. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. Please consider subscribing to the channel and share this video if you liked it with your friends to help the channel grow bigger. Thanks for watching guys. You're the best audience ever and I will see you in the next videos. Take it easy.